चेप्रोल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ईसीयू वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज बायोमेडिकल इंजीनियरिंग थर्ड बीटेक ईसीयू यूनिट नंबर 5 डायग्नोसिस टेक्निक एंड बायोटेलीमेट्री। सो इन दिस यूनिट वी हैव वेरियस डायग्नोसिस टेक्निक। फर्स्ट वन अल्ट्रासोनिक मेजरमेंट, अल्ट्रासोनिक इमेजिंग, अल्ट्रासोनिक डायग्नोसिस, एक्सरे, रेडियो आइसोटोप इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन, सीएटी और सीटी स्कैन, सो एमिशन बेस्ड कंप्यूटराइज्ड टोमोग्राफी, एमआरआई एटसेट्रा। दिस आर द इंडेक्स एज पर जेएनटीयू के सिलेबस। यूनिट नंबर फाइव दिस डायग्नोसिस टेक्निक और मेजरमेंट्स इन्वॉल्व्स टू हेल्प द डिटेक्शन ऑफ सम माल फंक्शन ऑफ द सिस्टम ऑफ द बॉडी। सच इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन मे ऑल्सो बी कॉल्ड एज ट्रबल शूटिंग। So the diagnosis equipment and their principles, for example, X-ray, radioisotropic. So these are the possible methods for the number 1 is X-ray, number 2 is radio isotopic, number 3 CAT scan, and various MRI techniques. So these techniques of diagnosis doesn't involve getting inside the body physically. Therefore, these are known as non-invasive diagnostic techniques. So non-invasive diagnostic technique. So in the non-invasive diagnosis technique, these are not traumatic for the patient and do not have any detrimental side effects on the patient. So the non-invasion technique are very sophisticated, which are accurate results without invasion of the body. So usually the method for BP measurement, which is called non-invasive, technique. So let us discuss the principle behind on this ultrasonic measurement. So ultrasound is the sonic energy at a frequency above audible range. This system or this technique use the frequency above audible, which is called 20 kilohertz. And ultrasound exists as a sequence of alternative compression and refraction of the suitable medium. But if this is, suppose it is some interface, so in this interface so if this is the incident wave, similarly we call medium 1, take a medium 2, this is the interface. So this is the transmitted wave. So this is reflected, reflecting wave or reflected wave. Some wave is denser, so this is called refraction. So this ultrasound exists as a sequence of alternative compression and refraction of a suitable medium, air, water, bone tissue, and it is propagated through the medium at some velocity, and it is also frequency and medium density dependent. So in normal application, ultrasound is actually focused into law of reflection and refraction. So the reflected energy is depend upon difference of the density densities between these two media. So on the angle at which transmitted beam hits this medium. So higher the difference in the media, the higher will be the reflection. So if the angle of incidence between the beam and interface is very closer to 90 degree, so the reflected portion would be very great extent. So the reflected energy is depend upon the difference of densities between the two media and the angle at which transmitted beam hits this medium. Higher the difference in the media, higher will be the reflection. So if the angle of incidence between the beam and the interface is closer to 90 degree, so the reflected portion would be greater. So another information here, if the media difference is high, that is tissue and bone or tissues and gas, so most of the energy will be reflected and almost no energy will be continue through the second medium. So in other words, how we can say this type of propagation path must not include bone or any gas medium or air. So an airless contact is produced through using the gel or water bag between transducer and the skin for application of ultrasound. So the density, so and the important properties of the materials can be depends. Suppose how we can say for water. So for water, so what is the temperature here? So temperature in degrees and density. Density gram per meter cube, velocity meter per second. So for water 40 degree 0.992 51529 brain, so 37 1.30 0.510 for muscle. So we have 37.070 1570 fat 37.97 bone 37.3360. So these are the ultrasonic characteristics of some materials in regular practice. The velocity of sound propagation through the medium is depend upon density of the medium. For example, the velocity of most body fluids 1550 meter per second, which is very higher than water. So the velocity through the bone culture 3360 meter per second, whereas through fat it will be 1440 meter per second. So another important characteristic of this ultrasonic is a frequency phase shift. We have here a greater formula. So delta f equal to 2 e by lambda. So it is an important characteristic of ultrasound frequency, which is used in biomedical engineering, so which is called Doppler effect. So if the frequency of reflected ultrasonic energy, which is increased or decreased by a moving interface, and the frequency shift is given by formula delta f equal to 2v by lambda, f equal to reflected wave frequency, and v equal to interface velocity, lambda equal to transmitted ultrasound wavelength. So these are the various parameters. So from this equation, conclusion is a frequency increases if the interface moves towards the transducer, so and decreases when it will be moved away. So if ultrasound is reflected from a moving object, so the measured frequency shift is proportional to this velocity. So in normal range, so we have various types of this ultrasound technique. So briefly, number one, pulsed model. Pulsed ultrasound. Number two, continuous Doppler. Third one, pulsed Doppler. Fourth one, so range gated pulsed Doppler. So in pulsed ultrasound, so the what is the brief pulsed ultrasound means, in this method the transmission of pulse from at a frequency of 12 kilohertz and duration 1 microsecond, so the returning echoes are displayed with respect to time and echoes are proportional to distance from the source to the interface. So it is used in the most of imaging applications. Continuous Doppler, continuous ultrasound signal is transmitted and a separate receiving transducer, so it will pick up the returning echoes. So the frequency shift due to moving interface, which are denoted, and average velocity of the targets are determined as a function of the time. Especially for blood flow measurements, continuous Doppler is popular method. In pulsed Doppler, similar to pulsed ultrasound, in pulsed Doppler, short pulses of ultrasounds are transmitted. The returning echoes are observed. So the frequency shift is observed. In other words, velocity and distance of moving targets are be measured. So, and fourth one is a range gated pulsed Doppler. So gating circuit are used for measurement of velocity of these targets at a specific distance from the transducer. So the velocity of ultrasound can be measured as a function of the time and function of the distance from the vessel concerned value. This is one type of 3D ultrasound or somewhat of echo. So the imaging of internal organ or structures of the body can be explained by this ultrasound principle, which is known as non-invasive technique. So by using this technique, we have great information regarding size, location, displacement, velocity of a given organ without any surgery or any harmful radiation. So by using this type of ultrasonic imaging, so tumors are identified very easy manner. And ultrasonic So by using this ultrasound imaging, So we have in imaging system which are comprised pulsed ultrasound or pulsed Doppler mode. So this is the two-dimensional ultrasonic system block diagram, and this ultrasonic block diagram, so we have various types of the displays are here used. So number one is a scan display. So in ultrasonic imaging, so a scan display is one of the method. So here we have some representation of this type of the echoes. This is a transmitted pulse, and these are the received portion of the concerned echoes. So transmitted pulse trigger the sweep of an oscillator. So the transmitted pulse and echoes are displayed in vertical deflections on the trace. So this is called a scan display, where echoes are vertical deflection of the concerned oscilloscope. Suppose what is the second one, which is M scan display. So in this M scan display, transmitted pulse trigger the oscilloscope, sweep the received pulses are used to increase brightness of the trace instead of controlling the vertical deflection, similar to like this. So where echo are presenting, we have clear Heisman small dot. So the brightness of the trace is set below the visibility level, so that the brightness becomes proportional to echo. So therefore, M scan of moving and stationary target with comparative to the A scan displays. So in the B scan display, it is a two-dimensional image of a stationary organ or body structure. So the brightness of oscilloscope is controlled by returning echo. So in the B scan, we have, suppose this is the transmitted pulse. So this is our concerned echo, which is for M scan echo. But this is the echo from stationary target. This is the echo from stationary target. So where here observed, so these are the concerned corresponding A scan values. So this is the important of various ultrasonic and display sections. In ultrasonic image, we have A scan, B scan, M scan. Now come to in ultrasonic diagnosis section. So this is the very important block diagram for ultrasonic diagnosis. So under that, echocardiography and echoneurography and optical scans are very important information. In this basic block diagram, so the ultrasonic diagnosis technique which are used in the cardiology and abnormal imaging, brain study, eye analysis, obstacles, gastro, so in all field of major treatments, so these ultrasonic diagnosis is one of the main application. So the record may be named using echo or sono words such as echocardio is ultrasonic measurement of the heart. Similarly for brain, echo encephalogram. For eye, echo ultrasonogram. So the ultrasonograph used for imaging the organ several position and helps in visualization for all four chambers and four walls of the heart. So by this system, ultrasonic applications are inclusive of a generator for the electrical signal, so a transducer, so necessary amplifiers and several electronic processing display devices. So the transducer converts electrical signals into the mechanical vibration, which in turn give the echo waves. So the acoustic wave enter the body through the skin surface and propagated in a predetermined beam pattern. If the ultrasonic wave strikes an acoustic interface, such as a boundary of an organ, some energy is reflected. So transducer pick up the reflected energy and is amplified, process displayed or recorded. So the transducers are available for 5 megahertz in various sizes, suitable application. So micro probe needle transducer are also available, which is show for the this type of the main scanning block diagram. So this scanning frames or scan number of frames per second. So it is having X channel and Y channel, X deflection and Y deflection amplifier. So these are controlled by the time based generator, time delay circuitry and transmitter. So in this way, amplified signal is transmitted through the output membrane where the concerned output is recorded. So this is another type of the simplified block diagram. So what a prototyped block diagram is like this 2D ultrasonic system block diagram. So scanning frame, X channel, time phase generator, amplifier and receiver CRT. This is the simple echo for echocardiography, 3D echocardiography for a heart patient. So the echo find major application in cardiovascular department, which utilize M-scan technique. So movement of the walls and other parts of the heart, which are displayed as a function of time, that is usually in conjunction with electrocardiogram. So a typical electrocardiogram is like on this picture. So the mobility of this value is given, the displacement of the echo per unit time. So the transducers are placed such that the beam crossed the chest wall onto the right ventricle, through the spectrum into the left ventricle and then through the left RTM. So the image of aorta and mitral wall, which is obtained by this technique. So echocardiography can be used to detect the fluid presence surrounding the heart due to the inflammation and escape of the fluid. So it may be noted that transducer selection is dependent on type of the investigation that to be performed. So physical size of the patient and the area of involved encountered depth of the organs that to be studied. This is the basic structure for ECG, electrocardiography. Similarly, for brain, electroencephalography, and for ophthalmology, we have ophthalmological scans which can able to find the retinal variations of the human eye. So in the next session, we will find X-ray and radioisotropic instrumentation. Thank you for watching this session.